that we have x plus 3 over x squared plus 4x plus 3, and we're subtracting from that x minus 2 over x squared minus 9. Now, this is a subtraction problem, so the first thing that I notice is I need to go ahead and distribute the subtraction through the numerator of the second fraction. It's extremely important to do this up front on this problem because this second fraction has a numerator with more than one term in it. And it would be very easy to have a mistake with your signs with this number if you don't do this particular step. So we're going to take and distribute the subtraction across the top of this second fraction by changing all the signs across the top only. Some people want to do the top and the bottom, but if you did that, that's a double negative, which is positive, so you only go across the top. Now, if we take a look at these, the denominator here has a very large polynomial, and this one has a pretty big one also. I would hate to take this and multiply it by this one, and this and multiply it by that one. That would be a lot of work. So what I want to do is see if maybe there's something smaller. The way I figure that out is I take a look at the denominator and I say, can I factor this? Because if I can, I can see if this one here has something in common with this one here already. Maybe both of them have a common factor. So let's go ahead and factor this one, which has three terms with a leading coefficient here of 1. So we need factors of 3 that add up to 4. And I notice that 3 times 1 is 3, and 3 plus 1 is 4. So the denominator here is going to factor into x plus 3 times x plus 1. So we've now taken this and replaced it with its factors. Let's take a look at the second denominator for this other fraction. And this one here, I notice, has a difference of squares in the denominator. So since this is x squared, it'll turn into x and x. And since this is 9, it'll turn into 3 times 3. And we can use our difference of squares pattern because they're squares with this subtraction here. So this will turn into x plus 3 times x minus 3. So the factors here have now replaced this expression here. Now I can look at this and say, okay, what is this missing that this expression over here has? Well, they both have the x plus 3, so I don't need to worry about that. But this has an x plus 1, and this one has an x minus 3. So this expression is missing that x minus 3. So I'm going to go ahead and multiply the top and get rid of that. The top and bottom by x minus 3. Now, when I go to the top to do that, I need to put parentheses around the expression that's there. The reason why is I have to multiply this entire expression by the x minus 3. That's going to require me to FOIL up here. So we're going to have to FOIL this before we can do our adding, because they're both binomials, and the way we multiply a binomial times a binomial is by FOILing. So now let's take a look at our second fraction. This here has the x plus 3, it has the x minus 3. What it's missing is this x plus 1. So let's go ahead and multiply the top and bottom over here by the x plus 1. And again, since there's a binomial up here, I need to put parentheses around it and then multiply by my x plus 1, because again, I'm going to need to FOIL this. Now we've built the denominators up to be the same, so we need to add, but before we can add, order of operations tells us to multiply. So we need to FOIL both the numerators in order to figure out what the numerators should be once they're multiplied out. So x times x is x squared, x times negative 3 is negative 3x. 3 times x is positive 3x. And 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. Now, these 3x's cancel, and the numerator of this first fraction is x squared minus 9. And the denominator is all 3 factors of the x plus 3 times x plus 1 times x minus 3. Now, let's look at the second one. If I FOIL this out, I get a negative x times an x, which is negative x squared. And then negative x times 1 is negative x. 2 times x is positive 2x. And 2 times 1 is 2. Now, if I combine my like terms, I get a negative x squared plus 1x plus 2, combining these two into that. The denominator matches the other one because we have all three factors of x plus 3 times x plus 1 times x minus 3. Now, our denominators match, and we no longer have any multiplication in the numerators. So we can go ahead and combine like terms. And I notice right away that this positive x squared cancels with the negative x squared. So that just leaves me with an x, and then the negative 9 and the 2 makes negative 7. So that's the numerator, and the denominator is all three factors down here. And the numerator happens to already be factored, so I want to see if this x minus 7 will cancel with anything in the denominator, and it won't. So this entire thing here is your expression. And again, you do not need to multiply it back out. You can leave it as its factors. So that is how you go about adding and subtracting rational expressions. You need to build the fractions up so the denominators match. And if the denominators are not factored, like they weren't in this particular problem, then what you would want to do is factor the denominators like we did here on this step in order to see what factors are missing that you need to use in order to build it up, like we did here on this fraction with the x minus 3, and we did over here with the x plus 1.